Hi and welcome to my dev stream. The name of the game is Critically Entangled. It's an RTS about extreme micromanagement, severe lack of time and ultimate balance. Today I want to make a hopefully very small adjustment first, which is every unit that I spawn should actually come out at the position of the main unit called the collector that was added in the last video and or the video before that. And once that is done, I want to prepare the tank script, or rather probably rename it to unit script, prepare that for multiple classes of tanks, so we can have a base script with all basic tank functionality like movement and health and destruction, and inherit from that to make then the more specific tanks. Okay, first spawning a new unit at the collector's position. Basically, we need to get the position of our collector unit first. Now, all units are, when they are spawned, are added here. I mean, in this, under this node. Which will, of course, contain all the units of all players. So it might make sense in the near future to have them subgrouped into one group per player. Not sure yet if that is necessary or really makes sense, but I think at this point I'll just store the collector unit into a variable on the main script. And when that is spawned, just store it there. I think this happens in the connection manager. Connection manager script, start game, spawn collector unit. This can actually return the spawned unit. I'm gonna rename this variable here because tank is too specific. specific. Return this new unit, so I should be able to get it here and store it. And when spawning any other unit, can always pass a position. And this is called from the HUD. Yes. Position, no, I think it's called translation. And I want to do the RPC call later. Let's see if that works. There's my collector, make it move. Okay, tank spawns inside the collector. Now it would be great if it had some offset. The selection marker, we are already getting the size of the collision shape, so we could do the same thing when spawning a unit. Except only half of that, probably. Okay, so we're getting the collision shape again. Height is what I would call length of the capsule shape, and half of that should be something like the diameter, no, like the radius of this unit. So we will add the radius to the x axis of the translation. This should spawn the unit outside of the collector. Except rigid body. Oh, really? Here? No. Player's main unit is my collector, which of course and does have a collision shape. Oh, it's trying to access this as a script variable. Right. So we actually need to get this as a node like this. However, still spawning in the wrong place. Let's see what happens if this... No. I mean, the length of the collision variable, collision shape should be something like this. So it should be quite... It should be enough. X axis is this one. just doesn't do anything at all. Yes it does. But okay. It seems like this doesn't really directly relate to the game world scale somehow. Oh wow, times 10 is a little bit too much. That's better. That's good. That's good. It still gives him a boost. Don't want that. Damn. This is also great. Collector's shooting inside himself. So that's that. Could surely be refined later. Looking at the direction of the collector unit and spawning the new unit always in the same place, like always in the back or always to one side. But for the moment, that's okay. Okay, now for making the tank script more generic and actually inheriting it on all other unit types. See. going on here? Like this, extends the other script. So I'm gonna take my tank script, save as unit script, and well, open my tank script and say this extends my unit script like this. And now there's a lot of things that we don't need to have here anymore. Even the projectile. No. No, I guess every tank should have its own projectile preloaded. This would be movement. We don't need this. Selection. Don't need selection. Input events should also be handled by the basic script, I think. Base script. Target point 2, fire weapon. Take damage and destroy is also in the basic script. Fire weapon would probably be done in each separate script, but not the target point. So I should actually rename this. Unit tank, or rather, unit plasma, because the plasma will be the basic tank unit firing rather slow projectiles. Let's see some cleanup here. Tank and tank. Move this. Basic unit script, we wanna have an empty fire weapon function, or maybe none at all, not sure. Let's leave it empty for now. Okay, so unit plasma has exactly this and this. Here, this we don't really need. I'm not sure if we can, if both of these functions will run. I mean this one and the one from the parent script. Let's test. Actually put the script on the tank. I don't even have the plasma tank yet. Okay. But still, I can save this as unit plasma to be consistent with the naming and delete the old tank scene. And where somewhere we're preloading this, yes. Keeping it all consistent. And here, where is that? Okay. Still move. Ah, I wanted to see parent inherited. Okay, both functions run. This is great, and I can still shoot. Movement is in the parent script. Firing the weapon is in the inherited plasma script. So this seems to work, and this means here. since both of these are running and apparently in the, of course, I mean in the correct order too. We don't need to set this again. This is all already set in the parent script. And the printout is also not needed anymore. I'm keeping these ones so I can make the units faster or slower. How? However, that's probably better done on a on the impulse that is applied. Which would be speed. Let's call this unit movement speed. Then let's see what happens if I specify this again in the plasma script. Let's see if this gives an error or just okay, already exists. So we can have a basic speed from the basic unit script. But I can override it here. This should be slow. This should be fast. Whoa. Why you do that? Bit strange. That's a bit strange. Only because it's faster. Seems so. Well, anyway, so we can change these for each unit. Yeah. And this should probably be just called projectile scene. Have you ever heard of replacing? What? Maybe not. See, the projectile speed doesn't belong into the base script. The rudder belongs here, and yeah. Anything else? Art is also related to direction spawn offset. Indeed. They are also related to the projectile. Now this should be probably calculated anyway and will be used in all tanks, so no. Keeping this here. But the projectile speed will be different on each tank. Okay. On the fire weapon script, just to see if this function also runs twice, which I hope. Okay, this one. Collector can't shoot anymore. I'm pressing space. Tank can shoot and also says. Okay, no. This one. The fire weapon function is only called on the plasma script here. As you can, it doesn't say basic fire when I hit space, but the collector does, but his function does nothing. Okay, this is, that's fine. I guess there would be a way to call the function of the superclass script, the base script, if necessary, but it isn't. Okay, so what else? We have the projectile. We will need a different projectile on each tank, and some tanks won't even have a projectile at all. I think, at least. Or, I mean, for a laser tank, we'll need more something like a large continuous beam and check all. Check the collision where it impacts. It's not really a projectile. However, it could be. It could be done with many small projectiles, perhaps. But they, if you move the turret of the tank back and forth, it will you will see that it's projectiles and not really a light speed beam. So yeah, some tanks will have projectiles and some will have another mechanic for that. So let's take this projectile shell C and save it as plasma. Script two. Oh, the projectile should also have a superclass script, I guess, because actually we have some things that each projectile will need, like the timer and the collision. So I'll just rename this old projectile shell script to projectile. Let it extend from that. This is in the base script. This too. Not even sure if we need a script at all. For plasma? I mean, what's different? Speed and damage. Some particles, maybe. However, if particles are not set by script, then rather not. Well, I'll just leave it empty for now. Open the projectile script here. Damage and speed. Oh, speed comes from outside actually. Set damage to 0, and when a projectile is actually spawned, set its damage to 2, some value that's from the supplied by the tank. Does that make sense? Or not? So let's quickly fail already. Projectile plasma. Okay, still does damage. I was wondering, this unit collector should not be named tank for one thing, and the other was I wanted to see which script it was using, the unit script. Okay. Don't remember if I did, but I already changed this before. Now, this is our shell model. Let's see if I can quickly add some particles to it. Yeah. Okay. Meshes have not been assigned to draw passes. Draw passes. Pass one. Whoa, is this supposed to be the particle or what? A material to process the particles. Process material, new particles. Whoa, okay. Just messing around. I would like these to be much slower, much smaller. And actually, I would like these to be more like 2D. Ah, 2D particles. Like more something like sprites. Well, let's see what this looks like when actually firing a particle. Okay. Should fall lower, slower. these particles seem to be living in their own little world here. I was expecting these to trail behind, but this whole thing, the whole scene is moving, and yeah, they are locked into this scene. If we don't have local courts, does this change anything? Okay. Yes, maybe. They are still just a little bit too big. Well, this doesn't really change. So it must be this mesh. I can change it here. Whoa. Why does it look so strange? Radius, and it has a separate height. See if I can add 2D particles. Are they visible in a 3D scene? I guess not. Oh. Yeah, it spawned up here. So, no. There should be a better way for this. like any anything like 2D particle 2. See, there are passes. He has some kind of star here instead. I have a sphere mesh. Okay, apparently we could load some. Load some external mesh or something. No, I want 3D particles, please. Well, okay, I'm gonna continue with better particles in the next video. Thanks for watching.